And then on one fine day, Farhan and me spoke and we said, listen, how long are we going to wait? Because, you know, it's also constantly evolving state by state.
Correct.
Right? Yeah. It's not that it would be that you would go into theaters and it would be okay, everything is fine. But this is more so, it's like Ghostbusters.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So it's for children. So we wanted to make it that kind of a film. That how do we get in children into this genre?
Okay.
And that is the focus. Will I do an action film where I want to see 10 people being blown up? I will. But then I'll justify it differently.
Okay. And is Donnie Tree happening or is it right out of your... Hi guys, this is Himesh and welcome to Pinkvilla. The multiplex revolution started in the early 2000s. And the same time frame saw the rise of XL Entertainment with films like Dil Chahta Hai, Laksh, Dawn and many more. And today, on the fifth episode of The Number Game, we have with us Ritesh Sidwani, the co-founder of XL Entertainment with Farhan Akhtar. Welcome to Pinkvilla, sir. It's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you, Himesh.
So, to start with, you have two films up for release on Amazon, that is Hello Charlie and Tufan, and both were initially meant for the theatrical medium. So, how difficult was it for you to arrive at the decision of bringing them on OTT?
You know, actually, both these movies, if you go back just pre the COVID situation, the pandemic hit, were actually, so in fact, Tufan finished filming on the Saturday and Sunday was lockdown. And we had already announced a release date. In fact, most of the film had actually finished in December the year. We had to wait for a certain portion of the film where Farhan's physically had to transform for that portion. So, actually, both the movies were announced for last year, right? So, we waited and waited to see how the situation was changing because every week, like you and me were receiving different information. It was changing month by month. And then we realized at some point that, you know, this is going to take some time. It's not. So it was a difficult decision. But I think it was also at the same time very comforting that we found a home in Amazon because eventually in a couple of months, the movie would come back because we have a very, very strong relationship with Amazon. All our movies, all our current films, all our previous films, everything is on Amazon. So it's like a home. You know what I mean? It would have been difficult if we had to think about some other part. So I think with Amazon made the decision easier for us. And then at one fine day, Farhan and me spoke and we said, listen, how long are we going to wait? Because, you know, it's also constantly evolving state by state.
Correct.
Right? Yeah. It's not that it would be that you would go into theaters and it would be okay, everything is fine in this part of the country. But if it was in another part, in the minute there is, you know, the cases change or, you know, there's a spike in the cases, it would affect. And likewise, you know, it would affect all the business of it going to theatre and that would become the noise.
Correct.
You know what I mean?
Like people.
So we just thought in the best interest, what is the best platform in current times to release this movie?
How do you see the future of theatrical business in India, given how things are today?
You know, I personally, I've been saying this. I feel that, you know, like with this pandemic and the whole world, we were all put on reset, you know? And I think it was important for all of us to be, irrespective of where we come from, who you are, all of us went through the same emotion. We had the same fears, we had the same anxiety, and we had the same hope. At that one point, everybody had the same thing to come out of this together, right? So the energy, so I think we all were reset and a lot of things got reset with that. And I feel coming out of it, both are going to coexist, you know? A lot of people were exposed to these platforms, which they were not earlier, because a lot of our country and the smaller towns and cities did not know that these platforms existed, that what kind of content was coming there. And maybe fortunately, because at that point, everything was on hold, GECs were showing serials and repeat. Those 3 months, a lot of new people adopted and subscribed to these services. And once they came onto this service, there was no going back, but they suddenly found content there. Oh my God, you know, we can relate to this. And they found new stuff. So going forward, you're going to see an audience which will know, like it's impossible for me, I feel, even when I go with a theatrical release, to reach into places which Amazon reaches. I cannot be in 240 countries. I cannot be in certain parts of India also where there are no theatres. So I feel what is going to happen is that I personally, I'm hopeful that the number of cinemas will increase in the coming year because we are under screen. And a lot of that will also benefit new subscribers coming onto the platform because on cinemas, there are limited screens. There's content which is coming in every Friday. Everybody, so in a couple of weeks, the cinema, you know, the movies are out of the cinema. So when does somebody, how do you watch it? So the next platform comes is your Amazon and the other SVOD players.
Correct. And you know, like we spoke about Hello Charlie and Tufan, they were meant for theaters at one point of time, and then because of the pandemic you had to bring it on Amazon. Do you think in the times to come there'll be clear bifurcation between OTT and theatrical content from the inception?
I mean, yeah, see, it might be like that, that sometimes you're making movies which you know from the beginning is that I would like to take this on an OTT platform and not give it a theatrical run. Also, like I said, right now, like I'll give you an example, like these smaller films which are high on content, you know, and you're getting new talent to it. It's very difficult because it's an expensive outing going to a cinema as a family, or it is expensive,
correct,
you know, and it's an effort because you have to travel. You are, like I said, and then because of the limited screens, by the time, even if the content is good, by the time it gets a word of mouth and moves to the next level, it's out. Because the next big film comes in, or the next film comes in, and then you get, you know, reduced into the smaller screens, or you will have show timings which are not convenient for people. So till we don't increase the number of screens, right, there is limited content coming every week. There are only 52 weeks and 52 Fridays.
Correct.
Right, so there is limited content coming in, and you have limited screens. The minute the screens increase, you'll have more films which get an opportunity to come onto those screens and be tested. But till that time, I feel that it's a very interesting place for different kind of stories, new content, where you can put it straight onto this platform.
And how has the lockdown been for Excel on the creative front? Because a lot of people have come up with so many story ideas through the lockdown. Because
so I think it worked in a very interesting way. We've, I think, managed to put out at least three different films, which are all in different stages of planning now. But during lockdown, it gave you a lot of focus because we could just concentrate only on content, which would have usually also, that's what we all do. But it gave us a clear cut time that there's nothing else to be done. You're sitting at home. So we started developing more stuff, interacting with different writers, commissioning ideas, you know, because there were certain, because, you know, you always make stories and about what happens in society around you. So there was so much more time to read stuff. So I was reading, I would call up the creative team, say, listen, there's this idea, I've read about it in this place on the net. You know, you want to just explore it, get the rights, or, you know, it's a great idea to think about if it can be made into a film. So I think a lot of that time went in, and we've developed quite a bit, which hopefully in the coming year now we'll start seeing them.
And what's the slate like for Excel in next one and a half year in terms of films, web series?
So we have Made in Heaven, which the second season is filming right now. We have two other series. One is almost finished in Rajasthan, which Zoya and Reema are doing. We have another show which everybody knows called Dongri to Dubai. Phone Booth as a movie, which will be out. Yudhra is starting from next month. Fukre starts on 5th of April. So we have quite a few films which are starting in the next two or three months. And more to be said later, but these are right now in the next two or three months.
Correct. And you mentioned about Fukre. It's a, such a big franchisee which has found love from audience all across, even on TV. So what are the pressures of making a third part of Fukre?
Actually, there's no pressure. There was a pressure, it wouldn't have been, it would have not taken so many years. I think it has to come organically, you know, because also what Mrig does is remarkable as the writer, along with Vipul, and because he's also director and he's given birth to this franchise. The story moves on, you know, it's not that just the characters. So where you end part one, about what would their next phase be?
Correct.
Right? So it's a continuation. It's not like, oh, now the story is over and we can start another story. Then it becomes easier to just jump. So there is a connection in two to what happened in one. Similarly in three, there will be highlights about two and one. About, so you need to see both to understand where they have gone to three.
And Phone Booth is a horror comedy with Katrina, Siddhant, Ishan, such a fantastic star cast on board.
Right.
What do you have to say about horror comedy as a genre? It has picked up in Bollywood majorly over last 5 years, if I think, since three Golmaal again. And
yeah, you know, I don't know whether that was the intention, because this was popular, we should go. We've never done that. In Excel, ye chal raha hai, toh we should do it. Because that's the wrong way. Because you'll never ever be convinced. So for this, again, the script, we, I mean, took a narration from these writers, Ravi and Jassi. They were amazing. And we loved it. My entire team loved it. And the first person I called up was Guru, you know, who's done Mirzapur with us. He's the director of Mirzapur. I told him, Guru, yaar, there's this amazing script which has come to us. There's no director attached. Would you like to come in? Because I know him and Mrig were together. They assisted Farhan during Dawn, you know. So I knew where he comes from. I've interacted a lot with Guru. I know the kind of humor he likes. I knew he'll be able to do the right balance with it. Because, but we wanted to make a it was very different. So for us, I mean, I personally am not a horror fan. Let me tell you that.
Okay.
Right? But this is more so, it's like Ghostbusters.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So it's for children. So we wanted to make it that kind of a film, that how do we get in children into this genre?
Okay.
And that is the focus. So please, it has got nothing to do with the films you mentioned. It will be completely opposite of all of them.
Okay.
In fact, this is going to be a fun ride. It's got a horror element in it, but nowhere is it anything going to be gory or it's going to make you jump out of your seat. Nowhere. Nowhere are we trying to create that kind of a world. In Phone Booth. So it's very, very light-hearted. It's fun. There is a horror element, but it's, like I said, everyone can watch it.
Correct.
Everyone can watch it.
And that's a first for...
Yes, it's going to be first.
Correct. And you know, one often associates Excel with modern, urban, cool, quirky content. And you know, if I'm not wrong, in last 18 years, we have not seen you make a commercial larger-than-life hero versus villain film, like person, one person hitting and 10 people flying. Is that one...
KGF hai na?
KGF toh hai, but...
But it's not made by...
Yeah.
So. No, but exactly. The thing is, I'll tell you. So it's not that we don't like these stories. When I saw KGF, I saw the film before attaching ourselves. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. So did Farhan. You know, now Farhan's version of that is Dawn. You know what I mean? So for us, it has to organically come. Do I not love watching these films? I do. That's why there is a KGF in the system. And now there'll be part 2 coming up.
Yeah.
Right? But, and we didn't watch, we wouldn't have liked it, we wouldn't have put our names to it. Right? So we did, we presented it, and it means a lot. You know, putting your brand behind it. And that's what we want people to know, that the brand believes in good content. Whatever that content is. Like I'm saying, when you see Fukre, it's when we were doing Fukre, people were laughing at us. Nobody wanted to do when we did part 1.
Correct.
They thought it's silly. You know what I mean? Likewise, now when you see Hello Charlie. So they're all different. Will I do an action film where I want to see 10 people being blown up? I will. But then I'll justify it differently.
Correct. And last couple of questions, you know, over the last 10 years, actually, I would say since Dil Jata Hai, there has been a talk, constant chatter in the media about a female-led road trip film. I believe that's finally happening for you with Farhan.
I don't know what you're talking about.
No.
I don't know. I think, wasn't it your platform which went and... You have better idea than me. How did that happen? Nothing is finalized. There are just ideas floating. The same time, kitne time se we are saying Dawn. Every time we go, Dawn kal ban rahi hai, Dawn shuru ho gayi. Kuch nahi hai. When it will happen, you'll hear it from us. This is speculation because we meet certain actors, we hang out, we're talking about something else or kuch aur aa jata hai. So there's nothing like that right now. Whenever there is, you'll hear it from us directly.
Okay. And even Javed Saab is making his writing comeback. Is that true or...
But he... Comeback, where did he go? He was writing lyrics.
He was writing lyrics, but as a writer...
No, he wrote Laksh.
That was 15 years back. So
no, so he is writing something, which is true. We'll be announcing that film very soon. And that is going to be an adventure film. Again, very, very different from what we are. It'll be fun. So it's his world. He's what he was known for. And his, and that is what he was just asking.
Yeah.
You know, like, aap logo, but there is not that usme 10 log mare. It is action. It's got an adventure. And it's going to be fun. So it's like a wholesome entertainment from the school which he comes from.
Okay. And is Dawn 3 happening or is it right out of your...
It will happen. If you ask me, is it happening? It will happen. When? Like, we don't know. But yes, we are wanting for it to be done. We have to get the right story and we are working on it. But it will happen.
Perfect. Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking
to you.
Thank you
so much.
Wish you best of luck for...
Thank you so much, man.
Thank you.